Let's look again for a moment at this rule 7. Pursue what is meaningful and not what is expedient. What is this all about? The way I understand it is this. You spend a whole bunch of time thinking, and then you come up with your best possible plan about how to live life. You have a goal, you have a strategy how to get there, everything. You have a model. This is how you're going to live your life. And from this point on, everything you do is going to be in service of that goal. The problem with this approach, which is what we could call expediency, is that your goal and what you truly want might not be exactly aligned. So as you go along, you approach your goal, things are starting to pop up that tell you that your goal is not exactly adequate. But if you are pursuing expediency, if that's your highest value, then you're not going to notice, or if things come up, you're going to ignore them, cut them out, and kind of tyrannize yourself not to look at them. And as you do that, you cut out a part of you, the part of you that noticed the exceptions, the anomalies. And the interesting thing is that that part of you is the part of you that knows better than you what you actually want, and you're cutting it out. That's why it's a big mistake. And that part of you is what is called the sense of meaning, which is a deep instinct. Peterson claims it's the deepest instinct, a sense of alignment, a sense of direction, a sense of being on the right path. If you don't have that, well, then there is something you have to look at. But if you're blindly focused on your goal, you will not look at it. So the truth behind rule number 7 is you cannot ground your life in thought. Thinking is a good servant, but a bad master. Rule number 8 is to tell the truth. Why should one tell the truth? It's again related to this. It's related to the fact that you have an incomplete map of the world, that you have a story that's not perfect. And the proof of that is that you're going to die. If you had a perfect map of the world, you would avoid that pitfall. And so the question is, what should you do once an anomaly appears? As we already saw, ignoring it is not a good idea. The better idea is to actually look at it and describe it truthfully. So to tell the truth and to not avoid the suffering that comes from having to admit to that truth. To not avoid having your story die and be reborn, and hopefully be reborn as a better story. So truth 8. I came up with, your map is incomplete, and that's why you need truth. Rule 9 is, assume that the person you are listening to might know something that you don't. And again, this is related to the very same thing. Our stories are incomplete. We need to recreate them once in a while. And we do this by talking, by thinking, by writing, by enacting, by representing, by brainstorming. All these are tools that we use to create new stories. One of the hardest is to actually do it all in your mind, simulate the whole thing. And it can be pretty powerful because you can go very deep and it strengthens your character, it clarifies your mind. But it also has some downsides. For example, you only see your own perspective. One can get stuck, one can go in circles, one can sabotage oneself. If you talk to someone else, you get the advantage of this person actually having another point of view. And then you see their reactions and you see what they think. You see the impact that your new story, the story that you're trying to create, has on this person. But for this to be possible, this person needs to truly listen, which means they need to pay attention, share their own emotions and thoughts, but not judge you. It's just they should tell you what comes up in their mind. And they should try to make sure that they have understood what you're saying. And so it might actually become a collaborative effort to craft your new story until it's clear. So you need to listen and be a good mold, basically, that the other person can use to shape and craft their new story. So that's why the truth I came up with for this rule is creation requires a mold. Rule 10 is be precise in your speech. Why should I be precise in my speech? What about rule 11? What about rule 12? If you want to hear my thoughts about that, the truths that I extracted from those, then look at this video. I'm trying to build an online community around understanding your own mind and mastering it and trying to live a good life based on that. So it's a mix of psychology, systems, thinking, going deep into things and trying to extract practical principles. If you want to go deep into this with me, then subscribe to this channel.